I've been practicing my own firm for about 30 years and getting tired of being in buildings where I couldn't control the heat, I could not control the heat or air conditioning. Paying for rent when I thought, you know, I could invest in a building. So when I found this building, it had interesting architecture. I felt it was built like a bomb shelter, 9-inch concrete ceilings. The windows were beautiful.
We purchased this Bell Telephone building approximately 20 years ago. It was always a dream of ours to be in a community. Ardmore is a wonderful place to work. Anything you want to do is in the Ardmore area.
In the Go Green Committee, our goals are really to help businesses become more sustainable and also then publicize their initiatives once they take action towards being more sustainable.
To get people more interested in our mission, I thought, wouldn't it be fun to do sort of a reality show making over a mainline chamber member business?
I was very excited to learn of the Chamber of Commerce's Go Green Committee idea that they would assemble a group of experts, look at your building, and give you proposals as to how you could environmentally improve the current building.
So there were several independent consultants who volunteered in this case to do an analysis of Silver & Silver facility. So for example, Catherine Swan did the sustainable business assessment.
Our role with GREENandSAVE is to look at the energy efficiency and the sustainability practices. In this case with Silver & Silver, there were several things that I knew up front. One is that I knew that the roof was an original roof and they were concerned about the roof and they did want to replace the roof.
We were asked to come in to coordinate the solicitation of bids for a new roof for the project and also some spray foam insulation for the interior ceilings.
I also knew that their HVAC system was more than 25 years old.
So all the systems are currently past their useful life expectancy. You know, we looked at what the upfront cost versus the operating cost would be. So the systems that we're proposing will address some of the comfort issues that they're currently dealing with, but it will also save them money in operating costs.
One area that I've noted that it's definitely would be a very good return on investment is their lighting.
What we tell people is, don't think of changing everything in your facility. Think of incremental steps. In our case for the lighting, it's not all the tubes, it's not all the socket lamps, it's the stairwells and the elevators as the place to start. With the LEDs, the payback will come inside of 2.5 or 3 years just for those areas alone. And these lights run so long. In an office environment, they'll run up to 20 years. In those 24/7 areas, like the stairwells or the elevators, they'll run 7 full years. It's the kind of thing where I guess the adoption could come slowly, but there's a comfort level for people to sort of walk before they run, and lighting is a great place to start.
I did know that they were also interested in solar.
One has to look at the cost per watt right now. What is the cost per watt on an all-in basis? The cost of the labor, the materials, and does that really affect their energy bill in such a way that it's the best use of their money? The challenge here with this building is that the HVAC system takes up a lot of room on the roof. And so the concept here that we finally decided upon was to build a superstructure of steel that spans the two walls of the building. And the solar system would be mounted on top of that. That unfortunately drove the cost up to the point where, quite frankly, what we recommended to Mike Silver was that we actually not do the solar system.
He told me not to do it. He said it really isn't worth the investment at this time. And while I was somewhat disappointed that I'm not going to do this now, I have a lot of respect for him to say something that was really contrary to his own good.
I have always been the one to be involved in renovating the interior space. So I was very excited to see that there were some very interesting materials out now that, from an ecological standpoint, are great.
Cindy and I have discussed about replacing the floors with bamboo, some other options with some carpets, as well as, you know, a cork option, which she absolutely loves. Cork is sustainable because the tree is actually used over and over again. Every 6 years, the tree will actually have enough on it that it is harvested off, and there is no need for hurting the tree or killing the tree, chopping the tree down.
I noted that the building has a swath of scruffy grass along its east side, which is open and visible from Lancaster Avenue.
We took a look at the area along the side of the building, almost like a courtyard area, which at this point in time is barren. The area just needs to be regraded, and the Silvers have asked that we give them a landscape that's simple but pretty. Something that won't necessarily need to be mowed, which is, that's great, because then that's less fumes from a gas mower. An area that will also help manage the water.
The stormwater runoff issue is a fairly large issue here in the township. There are roughly three large watershed areas, and they all discharge into the Schuylkill River. During any heavy rainstorm that falls both on lawns, on grass, also falls on roads, when the water accumulates on these impervious surfaces, it needs to discharge somewhere. And where it discharges to eventually is to the water courses in these watershed areas. There are a number of techniques that can be used to slow down the water. You can do that with planting areas, you can do it with rain gardens.
As I learn more and more about how to help businesses and institutions go green, on the one hand, you can take the first step by making your building more energy efficient. But the second piece is the workforce and culture of the office.
In moving more towards sustainability, my recommendation would be to create a green office policy manual, which we GREENandSAVE do for businesses. And what I would include in this manual are certain things like drinking water from a pitcher, no water bottles in the office, recycling all your paper, making sure that you have an area that's very evident of where you can put your paper to be recycled, to print on two sides of the paper, to make sure that you always turn your computer off.
In terms of managing the project, it's given me a chance to really reflect on the business owner going to the marketplace to wanting to become a greener business, more sustainable, and facing the dilemmas of wanting to be cost effective, having budget constraints, and then also being faced with all the technical material and how to make the right technical judgments.
I very much appreciate the Chamber of Commerce's efforts to provide a business person like myself this kind of assistance. They came through with really good people. They've coordinated it. They were sensitive to the needs of my business and tried not to disrupt us too much. And it's really come together to the point that I'm really looking forward to looking at these different bids, getting some help with analyzing them, and then implementing the suggestions.